Hello everyone, welcome to my class. I am an English teacher. Now today's topic is the stative passive. Before giving explanation about the stative passive, I try to explain the word state. The word state means a condition or a way of being exists at a particular time. Now, what's stative passive? Stative passives are verb-like words, usually follow be in sentences, and function as adjectives. Now, the first sentence is, the door is old. The next sentence, the door is green. In these two sentences, these two adjectives, old and green, describe the noun, door. And the third sentence, her arm is broken. In this sentence, broken is state. Why? Because the condition of the arm is broken. And I give you also explanation about, extra information about the stative passive. Stative passive usually indicates a status or a condition which may exist over a period of time. And also here, in contrast, the action verbs often indicate a change from one status to another. In the following explanation, you can get also some deep and detailed information. Now, we got married in 1999. In this sentence, got married is change. Why? Because we changed it from single to married. And the next sentence, we are married now. In this sentence, the married is a status because our current condition is married. And the next example, Jack broke the window. In this sentence, broke is an action because what happened at a particular time. And the last sentence, the window is broken. In this sentence, the broken is status because the current condition of the window is broken. And other examples I can also offer. Now, the first sentence is, Jack fell asleep. Now, and the next sentence is, Jack is asleep. What's the difference between these two sentences? While we are reading any passages or newspaper or some text, we can understand here this is Jack is sleeping or Jack fell asleep. But it has a bit difference. Jack fell asleep. Now, in this sentence is action because Jack changed from awake to asleep. And the next sentence, Jack is asleep. Here, this is John's current condition is asleep. And the next one, John became sick. And the last sentence, John is sick. In these two sentences, if you focus on, here this is Jack became sick. This is an action because Jack changed from healthy to sick. Became sick. And the first sentence here, Jack is sick. This is current condition. Just now he is sick. And other, if we can continue to explain this topic, now usually stative passive verbs are followed by preposition other than by. If you can or if you remember passive sentences, in passive sentences, sometimes we can use the preposition by. But stative passive verbs usually followed by a preposition, as a preposition. For example, I'm interested in Chinese art. Or he is satisfied with his job. Or Anne is married to Alex. In these sentences, if you focus on these words, for example, interested, married, or satisfied, these verbs are stative. These verbs show that person's or that people's condition. And also, if we can focus on the stative passive verbs usually comes in the English language, a lot of text, a lot of passages we can see. Now, I prepared the next slide, we can see in this slide and also other slides, we can see a lot of verbs, a lot of stative passive verbs with preposition. Why I prepared this list? Because this list is very helpful for learners if you can learn by heart these stative passive verbs with their own prepositions. And I think that you can learn these words, these phrases, and this stative passive you can learn by heart, and you can repeat in your life, and also you have to speak while you are speaking. They are very helpful stative verbs. And I think that students or learners, I think that understandable everything, you can improve your language by learning these stative passive verbs. Thank you. See you later again.